super happy to see this happening. Vinny has written over 500 compositions for large ensemble. And but yeah, he's prolific anyway. And I've heard a bunch of that music, and I know so many people that have played in Vinny's ensembles over the years, both here in Vancouver and Los Angeles and other places. And I really wanted some of the CAP students to have the experience of playing those compositions and working in the way that Vinny does with the band, which is a very special and personal approach to the music and to conducting, to composing. So this is super exciting for me, and I'm sure it'll be super exciting for you. What a cast we have assembled. A lot of them are Capilano University A band, but a lot of them are not. So want to thank my friend Brad for loaning the band and the rehearsal time that they could have been using to rehearse other things for their gig later this week, and instead they rehearsed all this music, which I think is really generous of Brad to share that with. So thanks, Brad, wherever you are. Probably Frank is playing with Bill. Yeah. And then lastly, I want to let you know that Vinny's in town for two more days. We're recording tomorrow, but then Sunday we're playing at 8 East in Chinatown, number 8 East Pender, which is a really cool venue. If you haven't been there yet, you should go. It's an amazing location with a lot of great Vancouver cultural history, and it's a great place to listen and meet other musicians and meet people who like exciting, adventurous music. So Vinny will be playing there with the same quartet you saw here tonight, plus it's a double bill with a trio, the great saxophone player John Gross, with Kenton Lowen on drums and James Meager on bass. It should be quite a night. We'll get started at 7 o'clock then, so please come up for that if you can. But without any further ado, let's welcome Vinny back with Capilano U, A Band, and everyone else.
So, just a couple words. It's been a nice week so far. Aside from a small mishap, these guys worked really hard. Everybody collectively, all the people in the ensemble worked really hard to play the music. It's not traditional music, and it kind of moves around outside the box a little bit. It's very textural. I'm using whiteboard to give cues, hand signals. And there's notated music and a certain amount of improvisation. And everybody has stepped up to the challenge and been really been a lot of fun for me. And it's always inspiring to see so many young musicians on their way up and really like kicking ass. It's really wonderful. So you should be very proud that you have this in your town, because we don't have it as much in Los Angeles as we would like to have, you know, creative musicians. We have a fair amount, but it's always nice. I mean, percentage-wise, you probably have more. But, of course, Los Angeles is just bigger. But without talking too much, I only know people's first names, so I'm not going to announce the band. And we forgot to make program. That's the one thing we forgot to do. So I'm very sorry about that, and I apologize to you guys for that too. So here we go. Let's tune into the fires. Give us a tuning note.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
trick, so take advantage of their good nature. So a couple of thanks. I want to thank Jared for bringing me out, and the university at Capilano, and once more, all the musicians on the stage who really gave 100% effort and beyond for music that they're not totally familiar with. And it was really fantastic for me, so I'm really appreciative. It's a great chance to, whenever you play any of your own music, your compositions, and you can be there to see what people do with them. So it's really very inspiring. So thank you.
Thank you.
That was fun.
Okay, cap people, we're packing up as quick as we can, taking all the